coming out of the Pakarika River system. This is Nokolgabyuk Island. Let's get the little one. And just a cute little marsh island here with a few flats on either side of it. The main shoreline. Yeah, we can go up it a little bit. He tanked here for about 5 minutes.
To go up?
And then this march, the...
See the relic shoreline reveal there on the meander. Portion here is growing. This is Ajalikak River.
March system up high for, well, I'd say 700 meters, stretching out to the bigger river channel back there with the shrubs and the trees. This is good here. could just circle this small island on our left here, up and down the channel as well. Yeah, just out and back, right in front of us at 12 o'clock. Go out around this sort of sand flat here. Yes, that's good. And it's not stretching out 300 meters. A few little bits of marsh growing on top, not much there. The marsh is not high, but it's not 300 meters. And we should go in this here for a little bit. And marsh down low, the lighter color green, and 75 meters marsh up high. 700 meters perhaps. Bit of a flat here, about 100 meters.
something else. It's something else.
That's good, we can do a loop here.
Only what a short way up this channel. Bit of biofilm on those flats.
On Marsh Island. I can tell you what length that they are beside the helicopter. Flat systems stretch out about 400, 500 meters to the right on the top of the park, 600, 700 meters. This is all mud, all flat material down low in the low intertidal.
Trying to get some mud flats. All bare.
Much the same along here.
Gosh.
That stretches out 700 meters now to the right of the helicopter. Another 500 meters.
back turning into a nice sunny day, which is great.
What you see is the shoreline.
Seems to get a little warm up here, but that's okay.
Hopefully, from where we're coming from. So, your track line's going to differ when you're looking at this on a map for about 5 to 10 seconds. First stretch in the back for upper solo bars there for 50 meters. And the flat system stretches out another, I'd say, in total 800 meters. No bars.
So is that as wide bare mud flat? There is nothing in the near shore.
Flat still stretching out
400 or 500
meters.
Pockets of darker water under the more silty water.
Heading in here to the Quigup Pass, up the plateau, stretching for 400 meters. Yeah, we'll do the island and then up the channel. And this marsh island stretches out 500 meters.
Now this
a little bit of a sandbar.
Kind of
at the edge here.
stop is out on the coast. Bear Sand Flat there. But whether it's sedges or eelgrass, it's still kind of up in the air. I was calling it eelgrass yesterday, but I don't know. It's tough to tell.
Marsh Islet is 60 meters wide and 220 meters wide. And on the shoreline there, it's like 5 meters eroding feet, and vines. So that's good here. If we could go down that channel to our right at 3 o'clock, we'll have to go all the way down it and then back up it. Pass. This is Agowic Pass here. And it's quite a meandering path. Here. Part of the sun angle. Marsh. these cut banks here, a couple meters in width.
Not sure why we did that loop, but that's okay.
By the water line.
These channels do have a tendency to twist and turn a lot.
And here it's only a few meters at the water line. So it's tough to see. Looks like mostly March stretches back 200 meters. Can we go up the channel here, and then we'll have to get this small islet, the one closest to this left side of the channel. We got the bigger one already. Correct, yeah. We could circle it now and then head out after. And we'll have to get this islet here at 1 o'clock.
Biofilm on the flats there. Brody Peak to Tempest Head Marsh.
To the right of us, so actually I'd say a little bit more than 800, I'd say a kilometer. 1,000 meters. Just head south down the main shoreline. Stretching out about a kilometer or two to our right. That's Agawak Pass that we came out of earlier, and heading south. Mud flat stretching out 400 meters to the right of the helicopter. And can we circle around the edge of that mud flat, just all the way around, just to get a good view? And looking into this flat here, marsh is up high for probably 900 meters or so, and then we're just gonna round the edge of this flat. Just to the edge right here. just a little bit. That's good, we can loop here. Just hug this shoreline up this channel here on the left. Low marsh here stretching out for 400 meters. Peat cut bank, a couple meters. High marks here for, I'd say, a kilometer or two, probably more like two. Marsh here for 50 meters. a little bit of silt here. Fine sediment for 5 to 10 meters of the water line. Surveyed heading out west to the Bering Sea. Today we're picking up the channel heading east towards land. Mostly river cut banks, a couple meters wide. The little town of Halakanuk. And there's most of it there.
Okay, snack, or I think that's what it's called, from yesterday. As soon as we get to the end of this channel, we should be done.
And, sure.
At least I hope so.
The river banks, maybe 3 to 4 meters.
I'm just having one of those days.
The bank river.
Last day of the survey. Can't wait to wrap it all up.
Can we go up this channel and then back down here on our left? Coming in here, this is a small island that was surveyed on the outside yesterday, but we're picking up on the inside.
That's
here.
That's number 55.
Riverbank, couple meters long. Stretches out a few hundred meters. River channel goes 550 meters. Back. down to this channel. That's a wrap. We are going to go get fuel and a mnemonic. And that's it for this Shore Zone Survey YK Delta.